Well, I figured I'd have some fun with this because yesterday when I was looking at the Mexican drug cartel stuff. I didn't make a video about that. I forgot. But yeah, I was looking at Mexican drug cartel stuff yesterday, and I ran into the Mormons that live in Mexico. They have like, well, I guess. It led to a discussion about, we're not really a discussion, but me investigating different aspects of that, what we consider Mormonism is kind of like a fractured, compartmentalized set of subgroups at this point. And, so yeah, I started watching this and I was like, huh, interesting. There's some stuff I didn't know, so I'm just gonna kind of go through it and make some comments because I feel like it.
Hello, in this video, I'd like to cover the four major cults and their doctrinal distinctives. We're going to look at the Jehovah's Witnesses, the Mormons, the Seventh-day Adventists, and then Christian Science.
I think it's interesting that this guy's a pastor. I don't know if he's a brief summary of the four major cults that claim to be the authentic version of Christianity. Okay. So I don't know what perspective this guy's coming from, but it doesn't really matter. I'm just gonna take it at face value.
Science. Some people would question whether or not the Seventh-day Adventists should be on this list, but we'll cover that when we get to it. Let's begin by looking at the Jehovah's Witnesses. This group was founded in the late 1800s by a man named Charles Taze Russell.
First of all, any religion founded in like the 1800s, how does that get, how is that not scrutinized? 1800s. They just started a religion. All right. Weird.
Charles Taze Russell denied the biblical teaching of hell. He began holding Bible studies that I believe morphed into his organization called the Watchtower Bible.
Okay, so he denied the biblical teaching of hell. Which, you know, in itself is pretty bold. Like, what is a more extreme position? Is it more extreme for somebody like me who believes that, you know, this thing we call God, the spirit that, you know, I feel connected to and always have, that all of that comes from within me, that I don't need a book or an external source to validate any of that? Is that a more extreme position than a quote religion that starts up and specifically starts picking and choosing out the Bible? Like, what's a more extreme position? Somebody who says my spirituality does not come from a book, or somebody who says, well, only parts of this book are correct and some aren't, but this is the true and living word of God? Which one is more bordering on blasphemy? Which one is more spiritual or less spiritual? Which one is more of the world? Which one is more, quote, new age? That's the question I have. Because my position seems to trigger people in a certain way. But all this other shit doesn't. They got millions of followers. Let's continue.
Bible and Tract Society. but eventually they just became known as the Jehovah's Witnesses. The first doctrinal distinctive, the thing that kind of everybody knows about them, is they make a big issue about the name of God being Jehovah. So Jehovah's Witnesses believe that God's one true name is Jehovah. Even though in the Bible, God is called by many names, Elohim in Hebrew is translated.
Here's another thing that came from within me, bro. I used to tell people a long time ago. My spirituality, I don't need a name for it. Names are earthly. My mama and my daddy pick, or my mama picked my name. That's it. Well, she picked my government name. I picked my name, my spiritual name, if you will, in the groove. I picked that. That's more my name than my government name is. And the same for me goes for this God shit, this Jehovah shit, this Yahweh shit, this fucking Allah shit, whatever. It don't fucking matter. This is all poppycock for book nerds. All right, let's continue.
Translated capital G-O-D, you know, God. El Shaddai, God is called Father by the Lord Jesus Christ. He's called Father by the apostles. He's called the Lord of hosts. Lord, lowercase O-R-D.
The Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts. You mean like the host and parasite relationship? Is that what we're talking about? The Lord of hosts. See, this shit, all that shit fucking, no. I reject all that. But a lot of people think it's all just perfectly normal.
Is the name Adonai. So God is called by a variety of different names, not just Jehovah. The second thing about the Jehovah's Witnesses is they deny the Trinity. They say the Trinity is not biblical. Now, it's true, the word Trinity is not in the Bible. But the question is, does the Bible teach the Trinity? And we believe it does, although there is only...
Oh, man. I mean, you just said a mouthful right there. First of all, you know, this Trinity thing, that's irrelevant to me. But this is a major point of contention, I guess. Well, apparently the Jehovah's Witnesses are right. Because he just said, well, it's true, the Bible doesn't teach the Trinity. But we believe. Why? What do you be? Hello? Hello? Did God give us a brain or not? Mine's telling me, red flag, cognitive dissonance right there. Not on my part. They ain't affecting my faith.
One God, there are three persons within the Godhead. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. It's not a person, and he's going to get to that because I made it this far the first time. The Holy Spirit is now a person. You know who else, funny enough, claimed that something else was a person? Mitt Romney, the Mormon that lives in Mexico. He said corporations are people. He was one of the big advocates for that whole fucking idea back in like 2012. Corporations are people. And apparently a Holy Spirit is a person too. A corporation, dead body. Okay. Fucking retarded.
So because the Jehovah's Witnesses reject the Trinity, they also reject Next, the deity of Jesus Christ. They believe that Jesus was originally created as the Archangel Michael. The Jehovah's Witnesses also, because they...
Well, you know, the first part of that I'm okay with. But then they had to go and throw the Archangel Michael shit in there, which, you know, I'll be honest. To me, that's all fucking worldly dogma shit. That doesn't come from within me. Again, I don't need names. I don't need names. I can have a guardian angel and God in my life, in my experience. It's a spirit that doesn't have a fucking name. Just like when I say my ancestors, I'm talking about a conglomerate of everything I'm connected to. But, you know, I'm the fucking weirdo here. I'm the one that don't get it.
They reject Christ and his divinity. They reject the incarnation. The witnesses believe that when Jesus was born on earth, he was a mere human and not God in human flesh. They also deny the bodily resurrection.
Okay. Again, this is another big red flag, right? Which I kind of agree with. I agree with that part. You want to say he's the son of God? Okay, we're all sons and daughters of God. How about that? So yeah, he was no different. Oh no, he's your Lord and Savior? Is that it? This shit is retarded, bro. You have to be completely fucking brainwashed. You have to be. There's something wrong with people that fucking... it's the book. It's the magic book. It's got a magic spell on people. Straight up. And you're a coward if you can't break out of that.
Resurrection of Jesus Christ. Jehovah's Witnesses believe that Jesus was resurrected spiritually from the dead, but not physically.
Okay, that sounds reasonable to me. I don't have a problem with that part at all.
Although, if you read the Bible,
I don't.
He had a physical body. He told the disciples.
Did he? Were you there? Oh, if you read the Bible, again, the magic book. The magic book, the dogma is telling you what your spirituality is, and you fucking dupes by it.
Disciples to handle him. He said, a spirit does not have flesh and bone, as you see that I have. But they would deny that Jesus rose from the dead bodily.
Okay, well, hello? Hello? The spirit doesn't have flesh and bone, but he was resurrected bodily? What the fuck are you talking about? Oh, maybe I'm just stupid and I don't get it. Is that it? Let's rewind that just to be sure.
Disciples to handle him, he said, specifically. Although, if you read the Bible, clearly...
It's fucking ridiculous.
Witnesses believe that Jesus was resurrected spiritually from the dead, but not physically.
Okay, sure. Sounds reasonable.
Although, if you read the Bible, clearly he had a physical body. He told the disciples to handle him. He said, a spirit does not have flesh and bone, as you see that I have. But they would deny that Jesus rose from the dead bodily.
Wah, wah,
next
wah.
The Jehovah's Witnesses, they deny the second coming.
You really have to be in fucking fantasy land, bro. And so far, the Jehovah's Witness sounds, you know, I know they got some wacky shit with them. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying they're not a cult. They clearly are. But it seems like there was a little bit of thread of common sense going on there that I can't dispute at this point.
Jehovah's Witnesses believe that the second coming already happened and that it was invisible. They say this was a spiritual event that occurred in the year 1914.
All right, well, there's the wacky shit. The whole thing is wacky. Is it? I don't know. I know I was born with a certain divine awareness. I was born in 76, not 14, so I don't know. But I know not everybody has this shit. I know that. It seems to be very fucking rare. Well, let's go, bro.
However, the Bible teaches in the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 7, that when Jesus returns, every eye, scripture says, will see him.
Oh, okay. When he returns, but he was resurrected 3 days later. So he returns from what? Returns from the resurrection? Because the Bible, which was written when? By who? Depending on which version you going with? All right, bro. I mean, your King James and shit, that was all, what, 1600s? You might as well adopt one of these 1800 religions because it's all fucking the same poppycock nonsense.
Next, the Jehovah's Witnesses reject the person of the Holy Spirit. They teach that the Holy Spirit is God's impersonal force. Remember, they deny the...
Okay. All right, that sounds reasonable to me.
The Trinity. So Jesus is not God of human flesh. He is just a man.
Okay.
He was created originally in heaven as the Archangel Michael, but when he came to earth, he's just a man. So they deny the divinity of Christ. They also deny the person of the Holy Spirit. He is simply God's impersonal force.
Okay.
What do the Jehovah's Witnesses believe about salvation? Jehovah's Witnesses believe that salvation requires faith in Jesus. They would say that.
Faith in Jesus. Not God, but faith in Jesus. Well, in order to be a Christianity religion, you have to have the Jesus thing, right? Because it's all Reformation Protestant from the Catholics, right? And the Jews, which don't, some forms, well, I don't know, maybe all forms of Judaism that deny that Christ is, or that Jesus is the Lord and Savior, like all these other religions have to rely on. Correct or incorrect? Because I'm hearing what people are saying, bro, and it don't fucking add up, does it? Nope. You have to be a fool to fucking fall for this shit.
Also, they believe that salvation requires association with God's organization, that is the Watchtower Group.
Oh, here we go.
Obedience to its rules. So it's
genius. Boy, that's genius. And that's what every fucking religion has in common, isn't it? Every fucking one of them. Ridiculous.
Jesus plus, according to the Apostle Paul in the book of Galatians, Jesus plus is a corruption of the gospel.
Uh-oh.
It is a different gospel. Paul said, all who preach a different gospel, let them be anathema. The Jehovah's Witnesses believe in two.
A what?
It is a different gospel. Paul said, all who preach a different gospel, let them be anathema. The Jehovah's
Anathema? Sorry. I don't know if I'm going to be able to make it all the way through this shit, bro. This is like... What a fucking blasphemy this shit is. Fucking ridiculous. Let's see if this comes up with anything. I'm already so annoyed at this shit, bro. Gospel of Paul was not a different or counterfeit. The good news, oh Lord, the good announcement he preached conformed in every way. Oh, yeah. GotQuestions.org? WeGotAnswers.org. Both Jesus and Paul preach the same gospel. It's the gospel of the kingdom of the fucking river. Okay. Was Paul the Christ too? Is that it? I'm looking for this fucking word, bro. To circumcise and uncircumcised. Oh my God, bro. The fucking dick cutters. The dick cutters. Boy, they always focus on the dick, ain't it? Oh my God, bro. Fucking stupid, bro. This is dumb. Fucking dumb. I can't find this word. Let them all teach a fucking blah, blah. Let them be blah, blah. Where's the quote that this guy just said? An anathema. Whatever the fuck that means. This is all strong delusions, my friends. I just post a link to this and y'all can go see how stupid this shit is for yourself. I don't need to comment anymore. I don't need to fucking comment.